Hey everyone, thank you for watching. Today's video I'm so excited to do. We're gonna be trying out some new makeup and I have a lot to try out today, so I'm pretty pumped to get into this. I'm gonna be testing out the Huda Beauty new nude eyeshadow palette. I'm very excited about this. I also have from Jouer, this is one of their bronzer duos. Also very excited about that. I have from CoverFX, this is the Power Play Concealer. We already know, I'm excited about that. I also have new blushes here from Buxom to test out. I have some new brushes. This is a brush set from Real Techniques. I also have some new brushes from Sigma Beauty that I'm gonna be testing out. And then I have one of the new ColourPop lipsticks. These are the Velvet Blur lipsticks that were just released. So lots to test out today. Why don't we go ahead and jump into it. Okay, so I do have my foundation on and I also do have my brows done. I'm still trying out the Urban Decay brow blade that I tried out in last week's testing new makeup video, and I'm still kind of trying to get the hang of it. But I do want to start off with the eyes, and I'm going to be using this Huda Beauty palette, which I am so excited about. I recently posted a video called my makeup FOMO wishlist, and I've actually had a couple gifts come into me from you guys, which has been so, I don't know how to describe a word I want to say, but just very overwhelming, very kind. Again, the generosity just continues to amaze me. I've never felt as much like community that I have in 2018 and then spilling over into 2019. I feel like I can just, I'm able to review so much more on my channel and just to create so much more content because of you guys and because of your help and wanting to help out an author in Iowa who likes to also talk about makeup on YouTube. And it's just a really overwhelming feeling, and I just want to say thank you guys, and you know, thank you to anyone who sent me something. I definitely didn't make that video thinking that anyone would send anything to me. It wasn't the intention of the video or the purpose of the video, but it was just really, really kind. And again, you know, the messages that come in with these gifts and the letters and everything, that really means so much to me. So thank you guys so much. And I'm really excited to test this out. I have been eyeing this palette. And like I said in my makeup FOMO video, I just wanted to try it so badly, but I kept trying to talk myself out of it because, yes, I love to be able to review on my channel, but I also don't want to get carried away. I've gotten carried away on my YouTube channel with buying so much stuff and really spending too much money on makeup, trying to put that into my channel when I shouldn't have been doing that. You know, I've talked about that in the past. And so I was really trying to not to go ahead and purchase it no matter how badly I wanted it. So this is really cool to receive this and to be able to try it out. So this isn't like brand new, it's a little bit newer, but I'm still gonna try it out today and let you guys know my first thoughts on it. As always, when I do these videos, I'll come back in a couple weeks to give my full thoughts on everything, but this is the palette and it's just so beautiful. I am gonna go ahead and swatch it, but I thought that I would show it here on camera. So this is a $65 eyeshadow palette, so it's definitely very pricey. It was the biggest thing that was kind of holding me back from it. But you have these beautiful mattes in here and some shimmers and some of these kind of like pressed glitters into the palette. I love the tones in here, the color scheme. It's totally me. And I'm so excited to be able to test this out. So it says 18 eyeshadows and 5 ready to layer textures. There's 10 buttery mattes, 4 multi-reflective shadows, 2 pressed glitters, 1 pressed pearl, and then also a concealer base, which that to me is pretty interesting. But I'm gonna go ahead and swatch this and try to decide on what kind of eye look I'm doing. And again, I really wanted to start the video out just saying thank you guys and, you know, for the support and generosity and kindness and comments on my channel and sharing my channel and all of that. I did also just recently hit 75K, which is a really big number to me. And that was really cool to see too. So thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it. But give me a moment. I'm going to swatch this out and then we'll create an eye look. Alrighty, so here are the swatches from the palette. I didn't swatch the concealer because, you know, it's concealer and all of that. I feel like everything swatched really well. I don't really like build up swatches. I don't use primer. I just use my fingers and all of that. But I feel like everything swatched fairly easily for me. And this one in particular is just really speaking to me. I think I want to do something kind of in this family here, like the mauve family, which is not shocking because, you know, I love mauve and everything. But those are the swatches from the palette, and this has me pretty excited and inspired. So we're zoomed in, got my ears on, Apologies if I'm squinting. We got 5.5 inches of snow last night and I film in front of my window and there's a lot of snow out there. It is very bright. I'm like pushed up as far back as I can go in my office. But I'm gonna try out the concealer shade because it's in here. I don't know if I feel like I totally need this in a palette, but we're gonna try it out. And I also got new brushes from Sigma and they're kind of focused on concealer. So I thought I would try one for the eyes and then I have another one that I'll try for under the eyes. This is the P87 Edge Precision, which looks like this. These are gonna be available on January 29th on the Sigma website. So I'm just gonna grab a bit of that concealer shade and place it all over the lid. Just using this as my base. Again, I have foundation on, but since I have the new concealer, I have not done my concealer yet. And I didn't do an eye primer, so this is just kind of what I'm using as my primer. I'm not gonna set it. There is the Bare shade in here that I could set it with, but since I'm gonna be using more of these like shimmery, sparkly shades, I'm not gonna set it just so it's a little bit more on the kind of like tacky side. And I'm gonna come in with this shade right here, which is called Lace and the Delium Tools. This is my 785 Tapered Blending. And I'm gonna go ahead and add that to my crease here a little bit higher than the crease and start to blend that out. So yeah, I'm going for something kind of mauve, shimmery, purple, pinky looks, you know, all of that. You know, we got Valentine's Day coming up. Like I say, the Super Bowl comes first. I do enjoy the Super Bowl. The Super Bowl comes first, then we can think about Valentine's Day. Who are you guys rooting for in the Super Bowl? I'm not gonna lie, some of those games did not go the way I wanted them to, but I think that I'm going to be rooting for the Rams, but never know what's gonna happen. I'm gonna grab a little bit of this Tease shade in the bottom row and use my Sigma E25. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of that on the outer part of my eye. Blend it in here. A lot of times when I'm trying out new palettes, I kind of go for like my go-to like techniques, if you will. So this is kind of like my go-to. Like I said, I've done my foundation, but not my concealer, so I figured I could use the concealer to like clean anything up over here and such. And I'm really excited to test out that concealer, but I'm just gonna go ahead and make sure that looks nice and blended. I think I'm gonna add just a little bit more of that Tease shade out here. I'm really liking the way that this is looking so far. I feel like those were blending easily. I really like the shades. So I'm gonna come in with this one right here, which is in Daydream. And I just think that looks really beautiful. I'm gonna grab a flat shader brush. This one is the Sigma cream color, the E58. It looks like this. So I'm not gonna spray my brush first, just to try it out and see how it looks on the eyes. But I feel like, I mean, I know that I'm going to spray my brush because I always do, but we'll just try it out first. And I'm going to kind of pack that here on the lid. Yeah, so you definitely need to spray your brush because that's, nothing really happened there. So that's a little bit disappointing. But I have my Fix Plus here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and spray my brush, get it damp, and then we will come back into the shade Daydream and see if we can get a little something out of it because I feel like it swatched really beautifully. So I have high hopes for it on my eyes. There we go. So I'm just gonna come in and apply that to the inner part of my eye towards the middle here. Okay, so I'm just working on building that up. I'm honestly a little surprised that it's not more like impactful right away. We shall see. I mean, I think it looks pretty, don't get me wrong. I'm noticing just a little bit of fallout, nothing too crazy though. So spraying your brush usually does help with fallout too, but I'm gonna come in one more time. See, I think that it looks really beautiful. It just took us a little bit to get there, but I think that it's coming together here. So once I have that all over the lid, I'm just going to grab my E25 again and then just kind of blend out the edges here. Alrighty, so just blending out this eye look. So first impressions, I'm more impressed with the mattes off the bat. Again, I like the way that the eyes look. I'm just surprised that it took me so long to get here. So, you know, I just used a couple shades from the palette. I'll use a few more to finish off of the eyes and all of that. But first impressions, I definitely wanted to test this out a couple more times, test out, you know, the different finishes in here and the other shimmers. You know, I'll try to pop into those glitters as well, but I will have a review coming. I'm gonna have to do something with that concealer shade, you know, put a piece of tape over it or whatnot. I've seen people doing that to kind of protect the concealer shade from the others in the palette. So we'll come back into this in just a little bit, but I'm going to switch to the face. So again, I do have my foundation down, but I'm going to pop into this concealer. So this is the Cover FX Power Play Concealer. This one was also gifted to me, so I'm really stoked to try this out. I've been wanting to try it for the longest time, and there's so many concealers coming out now, it's just crazy, but I'm super pumped to try this. This is in N Medium 1. Here is what the packaging looks like. So opening it up, this is what the applicator looks like. So it's a very large applicator here. So here's what she looks like. Hopefully the shade match will be good and all of that, but this concealer I believe is $30, so I will have everything linked down below in case there's anything that you are curious about. But I'm just going to go ahead and apply some here to my under eyes. I'm going to do one side first just so I can get an idea of how well it blends out in case it dries a little bit quicker. I'm going to be using the new Sigma. This is the 4D HD Precision. I thought that this would be really fun to test out for concealer. It's kind of smaller than I initially go for, but it'll be nice to get up under the eyes and such. So I'm just going to go ahead and blend that out. Shade Match looks awesome, so that's really freaking cool. I'm gonna get right under, it is nice, this brush is nice to get like right underneath the lash line to really blend that out. And again, I'm kind of taking the concealer and sharpening up these, the eyeshadow here on the outer part of my eye. So I feel like that's looking really good off the bat. I don't feel like I used too much concealer, but I still feel like I got pretty decent coverage on it. And even using a smaller brush, I feel like it's blending out really easily. I think that looks nice. Okay, let's do the other side. So I really like the way that this is blending out. I don't feel like it's a drier formula. Sometimes with drier concealers, you know, I want to do one eye and blend it out and then the other eye, but I don't feel like I would need to do that going forward with this concealer because I feel like it's pretty, I don't think it's like super hydrating off the bat by any means, but I also don't find it to be drying, and I think that it blends out really, really nicely. I think that is like a perfect shade match for me. Oh my gosh, that is so freaking, that's so cool. Okay, I feel like that concealer looks so good. Like it looks so natural. Like my skin looks better, my under eyes look better and smoother and all of that, but it doesn't look like I'm wearing a bunch of makeup. This is First impression, I'm really impressed with this concealer. I think my under eyes look so good. And I did like this brush too. Again, a smaller brush, sometimes I like to use, you know, my sponge or just a little bit bigger of a brush, but I feel like especially for right here in the under eyes, I feel like it was really kind of just smoothing everything out and really easy to get to. So again, this is another of the new Sigma brushes that will be available on January 29th. So I do want to set my concealer. I would do this every single day. I'm gonna use the ColourPop Translucent No Filter Setting Powder. And I wanna use one of the brushes from this Real Technique set. I did use the sponge today actually to apply my foundation, not the sponge, but I do have the sponge because I think that it's a really nice one. And so Real Techniques just came out with a bunch of new sets. They sent this one over to me. This is the Everyday Essentials. You have blush, foundation, shadow, highlighter, and concealer. So I'm actually going to use this brush for that. I think this is the one that they're calling the highlight brush, which would be a really pretty highlight brush, but I think that it looks nice for setting some powder on the under eyes. So again, just using this from ColourPop, I'm just going to dip my brush in here and tap it on the under eyes. I like little brushes like this for this task. I like that it's nice and kind of like fluffy too. So I'm just getting real close to set that concealer, make sure there's no creases, and then dusting the rest on the under eyes. So I think even with the powder, I think that my under eyes still look fantastic. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited about this concealer, you guys. I'm so excited, and I really did like this little brush too for applying the powder, but that has me pretty stoked. So I'm going to move over to some more of the face, and I'm going to use this Jouer bronzer duo. I'm just so excited about this. This was another gift, and when I opened it. I was like, no way. I have been wanting this for the longest time. It's in the light to medium duo. This is in Sunlit. It says a duo of velvety complementary bronzers that promote a healthy glowing complexion. So I really enjoyed the blush duos from Jouer, and this has the similar packaging to it, like really nice packaging. And then when you open it up, you have your duos in here, and then you also do have a mirror. So, oh, and you have a little insert that just fell as well. I am so excited to try these. I think I'm going to kind of mix the two together. So this one is a little bit lighter here. It's a little bit darker. I think I'm just going to mix the two together and see what we get. I'm so excited. I'm gonna take another brush from the Real Techniques set. This says it's a blush brush, but I'm not gonna use this as a blush brush. I posted my favorite makeup brushes video not too long ago, and all three blush brushes that I recommended have that like angle to, like I have a type for my blush brushes, you know? So I'm gonna use this as my bronzer brush because I'm crazy. Okay, so, and then like I said, I'm just gonna kind of mix these two back and forth and do a little bronzing here and see how we do. I'm very excited for this. I'm also in that very weird stage of self-tanning. I have finally started to self-tan, and it's like I self-tan and then it starts to fade, and then I self-tan and then it starts to fade, and you know, like shade matching and everything for me at this moment, it's just a really difficult thing of life, okay? It's just very difficult at this moment. So I'm kind of like in the fading stage, but I think I'm going to try to do a little bit of tanning after I get done filming this video and then the next video as well. Then we'll try to tan again. Just makes me feel a little bit happier in the winter as I look outside at half a foot of snow. Ugh. Alrighty, so I'm really feeling the bronzer as well. Did build it up a few times, but I think that it's going on really smoothly. I think that it blends out really nicely. I think that's looking pretty good on the skin, not gonna lie. I'm really excited to try this. I've heard really good things about the bronzers too. Like I said, I really like the blush duos. I've been liking a lot from Jouer. They're a brand that I recently started trying, but like their coverage, their concealer, I think is really nice also. I like that. So I don't feel like I came in as many times on this side because I knew I could do a little bit of a heavier hand. I was going pretty light-handed on the first cheek over here just to kind of get a feel for it, because you know, if you go a little bit too hard on the bronzer, then things can get a little bit crazy. So I'm also just gonna bronze up my forehead here, you know, the huge. I feel like the bronzer just looks like really natural on the skin. Oh, between that and the concealer, I think I'm just really feeling this right now. So it's pretty exciting. The brush as a bronzer brush too. Again, I just don't think personally I would like this as a blush brush, but I feel like that applied bronzer quite nicely. So hey, it's pretty good. Real Techniques does have really nice brushes, and they have a lot of sets. They're always coming out with sets. Like I said, I definitely recommend the sponge that comes with that set too. And I did find it on the Ulta website, so I will have it linked down below. But so far, so good. First impressions on the Jouer bronzer. I think that it looks really nice. I have some of these new blushes from Buxom. So Buxom sent over their new primer-infused blushes. So here is what they look like. This one is in the shade Dolly, which is described as a mauve. So this is the one that I'm going to use for today. And I think that these look really nice. So let me grab a blush brush, an angled one, and we'll try this out. Okay, so I just grabbed my Morphe E4 and go ahead and apply this. Ooh, that showed up right away. Okay then. Alrighty, so as I've been sitting here, I have the Sony A5100, which overheats. I'm going to grab my bronzer brush and kind of blend this out. I was watching Kathleen Lights do a get ready with me with her friend Jessie Smiles, and Kathleen used one of these blushes in the video, and it looked like she was just really going in there with her brush. So I was like, oh, okay, maybe I'll go a little bit heavier handed. Probably shouldn't have done that because that is a super, super pigmented blush. It looks very pretty, and it's more of like a dewy blush. Like I can see a little bit of, you know, like glow from the blush, but I'm gonna go a little bit lighter handed on this side of my cheek and see how we do. Okay, so that's a little bit better. So again, the shade is in Dolly. These are $22 and they have quite a few shades. There's mauve and rose. There's like a bronzier shade. They have quite a few different ones, so Yes, note to self, go a little bit light-handed and build up with the blush. Alrighty, so I'm not like a huge blush girl. Like, I wear blush every day, but I don't tend to get like super jazzed over a blush. But I do think that this looks nice. I do think that it looks pretty. And I kind of like the bit of glowy factor to it. So I think that looks good. So that one was Dolly from Buxom. I don't actually have a new highlighter, so I think I'm just going to switch back and finish off the eye look here. So I added some liner to my waterline. This is Pure On Point in Hotline is the shade. And then coming back into the palette, I think I'm first going to grab a little bit of this Tickle shade, which is the pink one right here with the Morphe M507. And I'm just going to sweep that along the lower lash line. I'm also going to blend that out with a little bit of Secret from the bottom row. I'm just going to use the same brush here. I'm just going to go ahead and blend that out, make it a little bit smokier on the lower lash line. I feel like the eye look is growing on me as everything is kind of coming together, and sometimes that happens. So I'm anxious to try out a few more looks with this palette for sure. For the inner corner, I'm gonna pick up some of this shimmer right here, which is called, let me tell you, Crave. I thought it said Grave, and I was like, that's an interesting shade choice. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pop this right into the inner corner. That looks really beautiful. I wanna put this one all over my lid too, let me tell you. I'm going to go ahead and add my mascara. I'm going to use the Essence False Lashes Mascara that's in my January Shopped My Stash. My February Shopped My Stash will be coming soon. We got my recap coming up of all of my thoughts on the January products I picked. If you haven't seen my new series yet, I'll link it down below for the Shopped My Stash. But I'm going to go ahead and apply some of this to my lashes. I'm also going to use some of the Flower Beauty Zoom In, which is also in my January Shopped My Stash bag. And I'm going to use that on the bottom lashes. So I'm actually going to do that first because I get a little bit of transfer with the Essence mascara, but not with the flower. So I went ahead and added my highlighter off camera. I just used from ColourPop. This is in Stole the Show, so I didn't have a new highlighter to try out today, so I popped that on, and then I'm going to do my lip color. This is one of the new ColourPop Velvet Blur lipsticks. This one is in the shade Y2K. I did get a couple of the shades sent over to me, and I did a lip swatch video over on my Instagram, so I'll link it down below if you want to see some of the shades. This one was one of my favorites. These definitely remind me of the MAC Powder Kiss lipsticks, but I actually like these a little bit better. I'm still not a like personal huge fan of the formula, just a little bit more like sheer on the lips, but these have a lot more color payoff than the MAC ones do. Again, I've tried four different shades of the ColourPop ones, and I tried a lot of the MAC, and I tried nudes and I tried deeper shades, and I just felt like I couldn't get a lot of color payoff on the lips, which was kind of driving me a little bit crazy. These definitely have more, and they're like $7 or somewhere in that range for ColourPop. So definitely a lot more affordable than the MAC, and I think I like these a little bit more. I still need to be able to test out, you know, actual like wear time and all of that. So again, I will be having a review for these coming up, but I'm excited to test them out and see what I think of them. So I'm just gonna go ahead and apply the shade Y2K. Okay, here is what the shade Y2K looks like. And again, I like this shade, I think, the most out of the four that I've tried. I also do like CA Love, and I used that in my Three Looks One palette with the Anastasia Soft Glam that went up yesterday. So if you want to see that one on my lips for kind of a longer period of time than a lip swatching video, I will have that one linked down below. But again, I will definitely be testing these out to review. But can you tell if you guys saw me wearing the MAC Powder Kiss lips that there's more color on my lips with this one, which is personally something that I like? So, I don't know, I'm curious. I'm excited to be able to test these out, so I think that's pretty neat. But after that, that is going to wrap it up for today's video, trying out some new makeup. Here is our final look. So to run through everything, the Huda Beauty new nude palette, I'm definitely curious to try this out more and really try a bunch of the different finishes. I really like the way that my eye look is looking. I like those two matte shades. I think they blended out really beautifully, and I really do like the shimmer. Once everything kind of came together, I think that it looks really beautiful, and I really like it with green eyes too. I really like these colors with my green eyes. I will definitely try this out a bunch more times and let you guys know what I'm thinking, but I'm really excited to test that one out. CoverFX Power Play Concealer so impressed with, and I still think that my under eyes are looking, yeah, I think that they look great. I am really, really hyped about this concealer. I think that it's going really well for a first impression. So the Jouer Bronzer Duo, I think that this one was really great as well for a first impression. I think that looks really beautiful on my skin. So far, so good with this one. Also, for the brushes, I did like the Sigma brushes, especially this one, the 4D HD for concealer. If you're a fan of smaller brushes, you know, it could be nice to get right up in there. So I think that these are going to work really nice. Sigma brushes, they're a little bit pricier, but they're really good quality. They really, you know, hold up through a lot, and they have 2-year warranties now on all of their brushes, which is crazy. So that's awesome. So these are going to be available soon. The Real Techniques brushes, I liked these as well. I like this as a bronzer brush. I think that was pretty good. I like that little brush to apply my concealer as well. I thought that one worked awesome. And then the Buxom blush, definitely a light hand is needed with this one, but I like kind of the glowy blush. I feel like I might get a lot more use out of these, especially in like the warmer months when I really like kind of like the glowy makeup and shimmery blushes. It's not shimmery, it's glowy, but still think this one, it looks really pretty in Dolly. So I'll probably test out a couple of the different shades and let you guys know how I'm feeling. And then I think we just have this ColourPop lipstick. And again, I'm excited to be able to test out this formula because I think I'm actually going to like it. I don't think it's going to be a fave right off the bat, but I think that I'm actually going to like the formula. So that again was the shade Y2K from ColourPop. And then after that, that's gonna wrap it up for today's video. This one was probably a long one, but let me know what you thought of all the products that I used down below. Again, I just want to say a big thank you to everyone for your support on my channel. If you've sent me any of these gifts, I appreciate it so much because it just means that I get to review even more over here. I'm so appreciative of that. And again, thank you so much for 75K. That's a really, really big milestone to me. And I get overwhelmed and flustered again when I say it out loud. So thank you guys so much for the continued support. I just appreciate it. If you guys did enjoy this video though, make sure to give it a thumbs up. I hope that you also consider subscribing before you go, and I'll catch you guys in Sunday's video. Bye.